Hey, this is Alan Yip. Welcome to Student Life Boat. Our mission is to save students from drowning in the ocean of studies and stress and to help you smoothly sail to the shore of your success. So let's get down to business of learning to study smart, not hard. So how do you begin? First of all, let me ask you a quick question. As you sit down to study, for how long should you study? Many students tell me an hour and a half, or even until they get tired. You know what? I appreciate the hard work, but this is not studying smart. So let's go through the brain science behind our learning process. First of all, when you study, as time goes on, do you remember more and more or less and less? Now this curve is called the recall during learning graph. What does it show? It shows that as you study for longer and longer, you actually remember less and less. Here, the higher the curve is, the more you can remember. So this is very important. Now, then how should you study smart? Well, very quickly, I'll share with you some strategies that have been proven to work for thousands of students, and just try them out, and I invite you to use them because they'll work for you. So the key here is to chop the time or chunk it so that instead of 1 hour or an hour and a half, you chunk it to 25 minutes. Okay, just do that, 25 and 25. So essentially, we are going to have three chunks of 25 minutes each. Now, I'm a nice guy, okay? So you can take a short break. And in between, and as you take a short break, how long should the breaks be? Make it about 5 minutes, okay? So every time when you take a short break, 5 minutes. Why is that important? Because the engine here in the Ferrari of your mind is running. You don't want it to cool down. So I want you to just take a short break, go and drink some water, walk around, go to the toilet, and so that when you come back, you're ready to hit the ground running. Now, second question is, if you have different subjects and you don't like some of them, okay, like some of my students, they say, I hate mathematics, I hate physics. So first of all, if you use that kind of strong language, you have to be careful, because if you hate them, or some students say, our physics really sucks, if you say that, you know what? This black hole of inferiority or mediocrity will suck you in. So instead of saying that, I think it's better to say, yep, it's challenging, but I think I can learn to handle it. I can like it, okay? Or this is important for my grades. So if this is the toughest subject for you, do you study in the first session or in the last session? Okay, so let me add the breaks here, first of all, okay? So these are short breaks. So we have three sessions. Do you study the most difficult subject first or the easiest subject first? Well, guess what? You should always tackle the most challenging subject or most difficult subject first. So that's how you do it. So in this case, let's say physics. Then if, let's say English is okay, okay, it's an okay subject, and go ahead and study English. Now, keep in mind one thing, it's not a good idea to study the same subject or similar subjects back to back, because what happens is there's a theory called interference theory. If you study the same subjects, now the information essentially from the same subject, right, or similar subjects competes for the same information. So you want to study different subjects. You want to change mental activities. And of course, in the last session, well, do something you love, okay? In this case, I'm going to just use geography as an example. So study something you love, study something you are interested in. Now, here's the secret. When your attention is the highest at the very beginning of your first session, you are in a position to handle the most challenging subject. And as you take a short break and come back to the second subject, and guess what? Psychologically, actually, is good. By contrast, is good. From the most difficult to something that is neutral, So psychologically, we like that shift, okay? And that's going to give you a boost in terms of motivation and interest. And guess what? Lastly, this is a really good move. When you save the good subject or the interesting subject toward the end, your interest here will go up and your motivation as well. So that's how you study smart. One thing I want to touch upon is, what do you do during the breaks? Okay, is it okay to watch MTV, to play some games? Is it okay to do that? And some students, they want to boost their mental energy and they would have candy, sweets, and soft drinks, okay, and ice cream and chocolate and so forth. And you know what? It's not a good idea. I know I'm sounding very rigid, but you know what? High performance or good results do require a high level of discipline. So during the short breaks, stay away from mentally stimulating activities. That means it's not a good idea to listen to pop music. I know some of you like BTS and so forth, okay? Yeah, I get that. But you know what? During the study breaks, stay away from games, stay away from YouTube videos. Instead, walk around, do some stretching, drink water, okay, and go to the toilet, so later on you won't have to rush to the toilet and break the momentum. And that's how you study. Now, one more thing before we wrap this up, okay? I want to just show to you what we are doing. When we learn, we are using our conscious mind. I'm using abbreviation. It's conscious mind. As you're watching this, you're watching with your conscious mind. But what is your subconscious mind doing? Maybe it's thinking, oh my gosh, I'm hungry. I want to eat a piece of bread, or I want to have crackers, or I want to have a banana, okay? So your subconscious mind is always working. Now, here's the deal. Is it a good idea to play games before you study? And the answer is no. Because as you study right here, the first session, physics, okay? If you play games earlier, right here, if you play games before the first session, as you are studying physics in the first block, we call these blocks, here games will come to the subconscious mind. That means as you are studying physics, your subconscious mind is thinking about games. So you are not able to focus or concentrate very well. So not a good idea. If you follow the system here, it's going to work out really well for you, okay? As you study English, for example, and guess what? Now you have a different subject at the back of your mind. And likewise, when you now study the most enjoyable subject toward the end, and you are going to have English being consolidated, being digested in the subconscious mind. And when you do that, you are now using the entire mental faculty to your advantage. So this is how you can start studying smarter. I hope this video serves you. If you enjoy it, please give it a thumbs up, share with other people, other friends, because they may be in the same boat, okay? And let's continue and check out other videos. And please subscribe as well. Thank you.